Greetings, all. Praise King Selassie, Jah Rastafari, giving thanks, all praises. The Babylon has got people under a spell. Now, we refer to Babylon because we tend to group all the evil into one. Corporations, media, big business, enforcement, the judicial system. All this comes from the Church of Rome. As prophesied in the revelations of John, what it comes down to is confusion. From the very beginning, Babylon is confounded. It speaks about this in Genesis. I'm not going into detail about scriptural teachings in this report. I simply have to say this evil force controls the digital communication. The internet is a product of the military around the world. But these militaries work together to continue to maintain that dominion over populations, to serve those benefactors. If one understands business, they know that people are driven by incentives. They're motivated to get reward, and many of rewards today are monetary. People are looking for financial gain to make their lives more convenient, sometimes to live luxuriously and in leisure, and other times just to survive. But this financial incentive is what drives people, is what causes people to behave and act in certain ways, which collectively forms the culture around us. Now, there's a debate between nature and nurture, or whether we're born a certain way and it's inevitable that we become something simply because we have a particular gene, or whether we are somewhat of a product of our environment. I, from observation, believe that we are a product of our environment, and you can have one brother and another brother that are completely different, yet the genes are the same. Now, scientists are trying to find those little differences in what they call the DNA sequencing. Yet, this is more of an illusion to make people believe in man and that man possesses miracles. Specifically through his gods, which are the idols that he has made with his hands. Now, I haven't been able to report, although I'm backed up with reports and information, because I don't have video editing software, because another one of my computers crashed and can't start it. I got off the internet years ago, and I go to the state library now to do my work. I would recommend all freedom fighters be aware. Even if you're not on the internet, your information is accessible. I now write on paper when I have thoughts, whereas I used to type it in a Word document. That particular Word document, some of my writing was changed. I wrote one time, "We are not troublemakers, we are truth seekers. If somebody took the not out, we are troublemakers. It's hard to explain these things because people just don't believe them, or they think that maybe something's wrong with you. Maybe you didn't see things correctly. And I mean, I second guess some of these revelations, but when they continue to happen, I have to not take them for granted. And older folks, some older folks realize what's being done with this digital technology as far as providing access for external personnel, yet they choose not to say anything for whatever reason. I think most people are concerned with the moment of pleasure, to feel good. And this system that man is providing them is giving them that opportunity. It's not illegal underneath man's law to fly around the world, hire prostitutes, and cheat on your wife, and lie. You're not allowed to directly steal from someone, but indirectly is permissible. If you can fool someone into buying, you know, some junk stock or what have you, you can profit off of that person's expense. It's perfectly acceptable, and if you can manage to get away with it, then you're going to be a big success story to the Babylonians. And so everything I've tried to do is expose these truths that I've come to know. Sometimes people tell us about this golden rule, do unto others as you would want them to do unto you. We know the scripture does not say that. Yet it does say to do as you would have others do unto you. And there's a difference, because what we want is not always good for us. You know, I mean, most people like the taste of candy. Yet some people don't eat candy because it's not healthy. Doesn't mean we don't want it. It just means that we've thought it out and made that decision based on what we know to be right. When you examine this golden rule and you say, do as you would have others doing to you, and this kind of thing, I think to myself, wouldn't it be nice? Wouldn't it be great? Because nice supposedly means stupid originally. Wouldn't it be excellent if others also spoke out, exposing some of these hidden deceits? And so, in my own way, I do just that. Doing is what have others do. Today, there's something called leverage. You can use technology to heighten your position, to make yourself seem more trustworthy, even at times, and more attractive. Is this good? Well, what choice do we have? You know, I never liked the computer, the technology, but I've had to learn to use it because, well, it's not what the Babylonian wants, put it like that. So let's just do whatever the Babylonian does not want us to do. You know, it has to be good. Remember, Satan is the enemy of the Christ. The Christ is truth. Satan is a lie. But we have to stand opposed to everything that Satan does. So I noticed when I started using the video editing software first, After some time, it began to slow down. That's the first thing you notice. Your computer slows down. You can't get as much done. It becomes frustrating. You have to learn to live with it, yet it is less of a positive experience. The second thing you might notice is things start to change within that system. And if you look it up, you come to find that this law enforcement has the access to not only just the video editing software, but your whole operating system. That those machines are made so that they can be remotely accessed. I've talked about this entirely too much. Most people probably think, you know, that I've got something to hide. But I always present it in this form, that this technology wouldn't exist if there wasn't people that had something to hide. And the technology exists to keep people from seeing exactly what it is that those people are trying to hide. Much of the threats around the world since 9/11 exist so that this technology can be introduced and so that it becomes accepted within the society. People think, well, that's a great thing that this agency can see what I'm doing, because if I was a bad guy, then I could blow everything up, is what people are being kind of spoon-fed into thinking. And I think it's more like injecting people with poison than actually feeding them. So when you feed, you know, you digest, but then you give out waste and dung. But when you're injected with poison, it just sits inside you and begins to take over your body. And this poison is a kind of witchcraft, a spell. People are seeing what it is that whoever has paid for that endorsement wants them to see. And so when they look in YouTube, the videos that first pop up are those that somebody wants you to see. Sometimes, as I've mentioned, content classification, if a person is classified as being a part of a particular group, say Rastafari, and yet they have differences with someone else as part of that particular group, then those videos from person A will be shown to those videos from person B in an attempt to cause division. Rastafari is the greatest threat to the Wicked One. Rastafari is the manifestation of Christ in our time, as proclaimed. And all these truths have been told, and yet people choose to ignore. And as people choose to live in darkness, they elect certain leadership to represent their cause. And I, people, and all across the globe are subject to that rule. We have our own law, I and I people. Rastafari has given us constitution and law. Even carrying forth the doctrines of old, those commandments set forth by our forefather, Moses, and followed through by the Christ, saying that all shall perish, but not one tittle of the law. And this is God's law. Man will say it's his law, but what if we went to another country where the laws are different, where people aren't getting thrown in prison for small amounts of marijuana, let's say? Does that make God's law just here and just there? No, because it would be contradictory. You know, God tells us our law. He says, serve, King Selassie says, serve Creator with all our heart, mind, and soul. Serve Creator only. King Selassie doesn't say, serve Creator sometimes and other times serve man. It's consistent. Our law is consistent. Man's law, fluctuating. It's free-floating. There's no real foundation. And because of this, there is no real freedom. If I cannot simply make a video, a simple $20 video editing software, because I purchased the software, yet I'm expected to go to a place with internet to get an activation key, and when I go, there is no activation key. It doesn't exist. You know, if you have to, let's just put it like this. Is it freedom? Are we free if we buy a house and every night intruders come in? Well, no, okay? It's not free and we're not safe. But what if we're sleeping? What if we don't know those intruders are there? Does it make a difference? They use our information against us. If we come up with an idea, if we think of a question, let's say it's the war, it's Syria, and the media keeps telling us that Bashar al-Assad is gassing his people, you know, he's throwing chemical weapons on his people. But we ask a question and say, why would he do that? That's the first question to come to our mind, like, wait a minute. These invading forces were getting pushed back. Bashar al-Assad was gaining territory. He was regaining his land. And the invading forces were losing the battle. So why would he use this moment to commit a breach of international treaty? So the Babylon man will take that question and ask it, because he's already heard you ask it. And then he'll, maybe somebody else who's called an expert, will give an answer. The information that we are giving is being taken into this thing, the Antichrist. It sorts out the information. And it's giving the Babylonian man those questions. What are most people thinking? Here's the answer. Now, if I were to say, what are most people thinking? I've got a guess. I don't have all that, the social media communication to work off of. We don't have the technology. We don't have the leverage. And all we're simply trying to do is voice our opinion. And yet, we're obstructed from doing so, or at least being obstructed from view, from being viewed. My brother-in-law was saying yesterday that, you know, he goes on YouTube to find out sometimes how to do things, which is great. That's how social economy works. We all teach each other how to survive. It makes our lives more easier. But he said he goes to the videos with the most views. Okay? So those views are equated with trust. If it has a lot of views, then it's very interesting, it's worth watching, and you can trust it. Now, if you're on the inside, you can get your views up. You can use the bots to get the views up. I myself wouldn't prefer this because it's cheating. And if I am attempting to minister the gospel, then how shall I do so by cheating? Everything is in the will of Creator, and we can't force people to know the truth. They have to come to know it for themselves. Only Creator can give them this power. And so the views are nothing more than discrimination. To present that lie, to say, watch this, everyone's doing it. Now, last time I checked, just because everybody's doing something doesn't make it right. And even Prince Martin King knew this, because when he spoke out against the war in Vietnam, his base of supporters left because they were afraid of something. Maybe losing popularity. Over history, people have been punished for standing up for what is right. The English martyrs burned at the stake for having the Bible from the Church of Rome. Collaboration with the Church of England. And today, people are still being punished, but not so directly, not so evidently. The punishment comes in slowing people's computer, not allowing them the ability, the opportunities to rise above the current situation, keeping people in poverty, the minimum wage today is what, $8 or $7 or $8? If the minimum wage had stayed consistent in real value since the 1970s, it would be around $25. And yet you have something like 5 times as many people that have a bachelor's degree than there was in the 70s. So collectively as a whole, people are working harder for less. And there's a reason for that. It's not because everything is going along just fine. Everything might be going along as planned. But if that's what people think of as progress, well, I mean, I just come back from being called to serve a jury. And I did state in my video that I'll never be picked to serve a jury. So I know that this was a waste of my time. I was not going to be picked. But I took the opportunity while I had 230 people to notify them of their powers to nullify the law. I basically got kicked out. But in that 30 seconds, 1.5 minutes that it took to tell people about their powers, it was much more worth it than sitting around all day hoping to be picked. And yet there were people in that room that did not want to know. They did not choose to know that they had power. That's just blatantly exemplar. It's a blatant example of the state of mind people possess to not choose to learn good information. See, because people are always thinking in terms of what they see, and man cannot see past his own eyes. And so they're looking at the Rasta man and they're saying, you know, if this guy was so smart, he would shave his beard. Right? If you have a crowd of people around you acting interested in what you have to say, you'll get more people involved because they want to know. They really think that you have got something. That's why these big politicians, they hire people to surround them and pretend that they care about what that person's saying. And then others flock to the scene. So this is the type of laws of attraction. So I and I have to find a way to get our voice out. It's really coming down to this. People are lost around us. They're not choosing to follow the way of the master. Say, hey, that's not our problem. And yet, it is our problem. Because again, if these people want to do their Google, they want to do their Facebook, and they're saying, take my information, I don't care. Or maybe they don't even know. Right? We know that this stuff has been talked about for decades, but it was hidden so that it wasn't brought to view of the public at large. That's how the media works, is when there's something really important, like, for example, you know, we're gonna take your information and sell it. They'll put the article out, but it'll be so small, nobody sees it. But that way, 20 years later, when people start to acknowledge what's going on. Yeah. The Babylonian can always point back to the article and say, look, we told you 20 years ago. And plus it becomes an embarrassment for those that try to bring up these issues. Say, where were you 20 years ago? So this is all a design. Everything you see on this screen, for the most part, is a lie. And it's being selected for you to see. You might get 3 issues of the day, and the 3rd issue might be the most important, and the 1st issue might be the least important. But what's going to happen is that 3rd issue is going to be just brushed over, and that people are going to be flooded with information about the 1st issue. So to create a perception that is the most important issue. So, this is mind control. People are hypnotized. So, I make these videos because I am under attack. I am fighting for my right to survive. And after it's all said and done, I seek the Creator judgment because I know Creator judgment is the only judgment. Philosophy.